So I'm an instructional designer, and what I found was that a lot of my current clients are using third-party platforms like Kajabi, Teachable, Coursecraft, and I always was wondering like why are your websites in WordPress? Why are you using third-party platforms? These third-party platforms are paying them. Of course, we have the transaction fees with our debit cards. They're paying for different like a percentage off of your course. So, say for example, I have a course. Maybe I want to teach WordPress, and I stick my class up on Kajabi or Thinkific. They're going to say, okay, well, 20% of your course or 20% of what you're charging is going to come to us on top of the transaction fees. And on top of that, you can only have 20 students in your class. And on top of that, oh, I see you have this WordPress course, but you have these other courses on there too, and you only do maybe 5 courses on our platform at a time. So I never really understood why they were using third-party platforms, so I asked them, they're like, oh, well, it's easy to use, it's simple, it's pretty easy, I just throw my videos up there, and that's it. So me, I went and was looking for another solution, and I was like, okay, I love all things WordPress, and I know WordPress can do pretty much anything under the sun. And what I found was a platform called LearnDash. LearnDash is allegedly the number one platform for building courses on WordPress. So it's supposed to be the most popular platform for building courses, but when I mention it to people that use WordPress, they don't know anything about it. And so when I came to the December meeting, I mentioned to you guys, hey, I know about this platform that maybe you guys would be interested in. So what I did find is that a lot of big universities use WordPress. LearnDash. Infusionsoft uses LearnDash. University of Florida uses LearnDash. WordPress Elevation and ProBlogger use LearnDash. So Infusionsoft uses LearnDash to actually train their staff. So they don't. It's not something for the outside. They actually use it to train their staff on customer support, tech support, stuff like that. So maybe that's why it's kind of like this hidden gem is people like small business owners, which are the clients I have. They don't know that LearnDash is available and that it is really, really easy to use. So, and I'm a designer, so I know that a lot of you guys are developers, and that's one of the things that I learned a lot about LearnDash is it's very visual, it's very point and click, there's no coding, there's no programming. My husband's an IT, he's telling me, you need to learn coding, you need to learn how to do developing because we both, and I kind of just copy paste and cheat my way around it. I'm a visual person, so I'm like, I just want it to look good, and I'll get a developer to make it work and do the special things that I can't figure out. So I like LearnDash because I don't have to do any coding or anything like that. So this is the price for LearnDash. So LearnDash has a fee. So you can have one site license. So say, for example, you're just doing it for yourself. You can have one site. Or 10 sites or 25 sites, and then you have different features, course forums, certificates, drip feed, things like that. So what I have is the up to 25 licenses. This is the problem that I find with it is, well, after you've done 25 sites for different clients, you have to call them specifically, you have to call them directly and say, hey, I need more licenses, and they charge you per license, which can get expensive. So if you're a big company and you have a lot of clients that you're working with, this is to be the only drawback that I see. Let's see. So another thing that I like about LearnDash is there's another program called BuddyBoss. BuddyBoss works with LearnDash and it turns your learning management system into kind of like a social network. So it's basically like Facebook for your online courses. So not only are your the students of the course able to take classes and do their assignments, but they can also network and socialize with one another. They can do private messaging. So it's almost kind of like you have a blog or you have your feed of social interaction going on, forums and groups that are going on that are specific to each course. So say, here's the WordPress course, here's the group for that course, and these are the forums for that course. And then here's another course on JavaScript and PHP, and that can have another group, another forum for that specific course. And then on the back end, you can say who has access to what and who doesn't have access to it. So these are about some of the different features, integrations. So it works with WooCommerce, which myself as a designer, I like. It also works with Buddy Press, which is another kind of typical forum that small business users use. And I like it because basically it, you know, sometimes you'll use a different plugin on WordPress and it breaks your entire site. So I like this, the fact that it works with everything. I can update a course for my client and it's already connected to their WooCommerce site that they're used to using. So it's not like, oh, well, I'm already using this and now I'm going to use this new thing and now they don't work together. So it works really well with WooCommerce. It also works really well with Ultimate members. So if you want your courses to only be available for members and not just anyone to be able to click in like Udacity or Udemy where they can just take a course, it has to be by invitation. You can give them registration code so that they only have access to your courses, and only you can say, well, you only have access to the courses, but maybe your membership level doesn't also give you access to the social part of it or the course. So you can separate the two. You can have different levels of membership or different levels of student levels. So you can say maybe this is a gold member, this is a silver member, this is a bronze member. And depending on which member type you are, you have access to different courses and not the other ones. So that's what I just talked about, was the membership level, the easy payments. It also works really good with different social media. So a lot of people, I don't want another password I have to use, so it works with social login integration. This is, like I said, some of the things that it works with, WordPress, WooCommerce. So the other thing is, so LearnDash works with any WordPress theme, or say for example, you have developers who design a custom theme for your customers, and they want it to be a learning management system. So it will work with any theme. It comes with a really generic theme that's really ugly. And so there's what they call the boss theme that works with LearnDash, and it basically makes it look really pretty. So it makes it look kind of like Facebook, but the colors are different. But so you have your right and your left column, and your center column, your header, and your footer, but it's also very, very mobile friendly. So that's, I think, a really important thing, is a lot of people, when they develop online courses, they're not very mobile-friendly, so you're having to slide your on your phone from left to right, where you just want to be able to just go up and down. And so that does it for you, and it's just a theme that you're able to install. Once again, they have license restrictions on the theme, on the Buddy theme, depending on how many sites you're going to do. And once again, this is what I find to be a problem. Yes, you know, we gotta make money, but I just would like for there to be an option to have unlimited licensing. If I'm a designer, I'm a developer, I want to be able to use this as many times as I like, and I don't have to keep paying for it. So this is just a comparison of the features of those third-party platforms. I picked Teachable and Thinkific because they are the number one, they're the popular that third-party platforms that online instructors are using. And what I learned is that it's not necessarily quote-unquote online instructors. What they are their coaches, their business coaches, their people who are teaching is not necessarily their first thing, but they want to teach what they are doing, like maybe they're a yoga instructor. They want to teach yoga, but they don't want to manage their online course, and that's why they're using Thinkific at Teachable. So these are just some of the features, and like I was mentioning, is, you know, these transaction fees and then these standard packages. So if I'm paying $279 a month, or, you know, if my customer's paying $279 a month for Thinkific or Teachable to move from one course or for five courses, they're going to save a lot more money by using LearnDash, because it's just one fee you pay one time for up to 25 licenses, and of course, they don't need 25 licenses, so just the individual is still going to save them money. It's not $300 every month, it's $200 or $300 one time. That's it. Do we have questions? Yes.
The first thing I think of when I see stuff like that is, how easy is it to steal? So a lot of these, like Zeta.com courses or whatever, you'll watch them, and then you'll also see them on YouTube. Mm-hmm. So are people like stealing this stuff? Is there any protection?
So from what I haven't seen anyone sell any courses. This is actually something that I'm testing out myself, because I'm creating a course on LearnDash. So there is, I think anything with technology can be, anything can be stolen. Maybe we can hack into Facebook. So there are features where you can put password protections on your courses, password protections on the page that has the course information, the course content. I think it would kind of be a pain in the butt to have your password for every course you take. But yeah, I think it's possible. I think anything can happen.
What do you so do you host the videos on your WordPress or do you host those with like Vimeo or like third party?
So I host my videos with YouTube or Vimeo, and I do that because that's another way to make a private listing so only the people who have access to your course have them. If you have a private server and your hosting company, or you can use like Amazon as theirs. Because I feel like when you're putting your videos and your files on your own server, it really slows it down, locks down. So I always think of third parties in there.
The video really locked in when you didn't have a file table.
Yeah, you get a list, so it's like I have a certain URLs here.
Yeah. Yeah, I think Vimeo has a lot more protection features than YouTube does.